Configuring your Micromate to use a cellular modem and autocall home can save you time and energy by automatically sending your monitoring data directly to the cloud or to your computer. You will no longer have to go to the monitoring station to collect your data. This video will show you how to configure the Micromate, the cellular modem, and THOR autocall home. We recommend using the Sierra Wireless AirLink LS300, the RV50, and the GX400 modems. These modems have been tested and are supported by Instantel. In this video, we demonstrate how to configure the AirLink RV50 modem. It is important to note the modem requires a public static IP address. We recommend you only use the Sabrent CB-FTDI USB to serial cable. To insert the SIM card into your modem, you'll need to remove the protective cover. Insert the SIM card, then replace the protective cover. We highly recommend configuring the modem in your office before installing it in the field. Connect the antenna to the modem. The optional diversity antenna can be used to improve the signal strength. Connect the Sabrent USB cable to the serial port of the modem. The other end of the cable will be connected to the Micromate later in the video. Plug in the modem power supply to the power outlet and then connect it to the modem. Once power is supplied to the modem, it will initialize. This will take approximately 60 seconds. The signal LED indicates the signal strength. A good signal strength is indicated by a solid green LED. Amber indicates a fair signal strength. If the LED is red or flashing amber, relocate the antenna to improve the signal strength. Open a web browser like Chrome or Firefox and enter the public static IP address of your modem and the default port number for the ACE manager, 9191. The IP address is a set of 4 3-digit numbers separated by periods. This is followed by a colon and the default port number. This opens the ACE manager web application and allows you to log in to the modem. Use the default username user and the default password 12345. Once you have successfully connected to the modem, several settings will need to be modified for the modem to operate properly. Select the Serial tab in ACE Manager application. Set the serial port to Enabled. Set the startup mode default to TCP. Any changes are highlighted in yellow until they are applied to the modem. Set the configure serial ports to 115,200. This is the baud rate and must match the value you enter into the Micromate later in the video. 8N1. Set the flow control to none. Set the DB9 serial echo to disabled. Set the data forwarding timeout to 5. Set the data forwarding character to 0. Set the device port to 9034. Set the serial MTU to 1304. The destination port and destination address is where your recorded event data will be sent. To send the data to Vision, Instantel's cloud hosting data service, set the destination port to 8070 and destination address to 209.217.83.116. To send the data to your own computer, enter the specific port number and IP address of your computer instead of the Vision destination port and address. If this is the first time you're configuring a unit to send data to your computer, we recommend contacting your IT specialist for the port number and IP address. The IT specialist will have to route the data received on this port and IP address to your THOR computer. The last setting in this section is the default dial mode. This should be set to TCP. Ensure the advanced settings are: set the assert DSR to in data mode. Set the assert DCD to in data mode. Set the DTR mode to use DTR. Set the quiet mode to disable. Set the AT verbose mode to verbose. Set the call progress result mode to disable. Set the convert 12-digit numbers to IP address to use as name. Set the disable ATZ reset to off. Set the IP list dial to disable. Set the keep alive mode to disable. Set the keep alive delay to 10. Set the TCP auto answer to enable. set the TCP connection timeout to 30 seconds, set the TCP idle timeout to 65, set the TCP idle timeout units to second, set the TCP connect response delay to 0, set the include device ID on TCP connect to disable. The device ID prefix and suffix are blank. And set the send carriage return line feed after the device ID to no CRLF. The UDP and done settings can be ignored. Select the apply button to save these. To complete the setup, the modem must be reset. To reset the modem, press the reboot button at the top of the screen. This will also log you out of the modem. Now let's set up the Micromate. Make sure your Micromate is at the home screen displaying the ready to monitor message. If you're not at this screen, press cancel key until the screen is displayed. Select the auto call home shortcut icon at the bottom of the screen. In this menu, ensure that auto call home is enabled. The session timeout is set to 30 minutes. Setting the time can be done by swiping the spinner wheel or using the arrow keys. The modem is set to generic, and the modem baud rate is set the same as it was in the modem, 115,200. It is worth noting that the session timeout is the amount of time the unit will stay connected to transfer the event data. If the session times out for any reason before all the data is transferred, the call home session will be terminated. No data will be lost as a result of the session ending. The Micromate will retry sending the data the next time it is connected. To save these settings, press the save icon at the top of the screen, located to the left of the question mark. Once the settings are saved, the Ready to Monitor screen is displayed. Connect the free end of the USB to serial cable to the Micromate and make sure the modem is powered on. Start THOR by double-clicking on the THOR icon that was added to your desktop when you installed THOR. To ensure THOR can communicate with the Micromate, select the Units tab. If the unit serial number does not appear in the list of units, click the Add icon at the top right of the Details window. If the serial number already exists, select the unit and press the Edit button. Enter a name for this unit. This could indicate where the unit is located, for example, 101 Main Street, Northeast corner. Enter a description for this unit. This could describe the monitoring equipment, for example, ISC, geophone, and linear microphone. Button to enter the serial number. Set the unit type to Micromate. Set the communication to TCP. Set the IP address to the public static IP address of the modem. Set the port number to 9034. And set the check monitoring unit automatically to use the preference settings. Press the OK button to save these settings. With the unit serial number highlighted, click the green refresh icon at the top right of the details window. This will force THOR to communicate to the unit through the modem. If THOR is successful in establishing a communication, a green check mark will appear on the unit icon and the dashboard will be updated. In the Manage Units window, select the auto call home setup at the bottom right of the dashboard. THOR will display the current auto call home settings. Make sure auto call home is enabled for the unit and the unit is set to call home after an event. If any of these settings are changed, press the apply button to send the updated information to the unit. Press the done button to exit the screen. The last step is to ensure auto call home is running on THOR. Select the auto call home tab at the top of the screen and open the general configuration options. Ensure the TCP port number matches the destination port entered in the modem. In this video, we use the port number 8070. Press the start button. To confirm the system has been configured properly, ensure the modem signal strength is green and the Micromate is monitoring in the waveform mode. Shake the geophone to create an event. Once the event has been recorded, the Micromate will establish the connection and transfer the event to THOR. Ensure the event is transferred to your PC. For additional information, please refer to the Auto Call Home section of the THOR User Manual.